Hi guys, welcome to Keshav Astro. Today I'm going to talk about something interesting and really exciting which I'm working on right now. It's called BE stars. So I'm presently doing my research in this area. Also, I'm doing my work in exoplanets. But my main research area currently is BE stars. So what I understood about these BE stars and why it's so exciting is the reason is it is an unsolved problem. So it's a 150-year unsolved problem in physics, which might even win a Nobel Prize if somebody solves this. So I'll explain exactly what is BE stars, and also I will in a simple way, as a layman can understand, and what exactly is this open problem, and where you are, you have to pay your attention. Maybe you might win a Nobel Prize by solving this. One of you watching this video could eventually win a Nobel Prize solving this. You never know. Let's get into the dive into the subject. Like, what are these BE stars? BE stars are B-type emission stars. So what is B-type? What is emission? So B-type is basically a stellar classification. So like every star, we say based on its how hot it is, we give an alphabet to it. So what happens is we have a hottest star O, and the stellar classification goes like this: O, B, A, F, G, K, M. So O is the hottest and M is the coldest, and our sun is a G-type star. And we talk about this B-type stars, so hot stars. It's a hot star. So imagine a huge hot star, very huge and massive blue color star which is spinning very fast, and it is ejecting disk whenever it wants, like dust kind of a disk. It's a decretion disk. It's not accretion disk, which we will see in the star formation time. So it's a decretion disk. So you can see the it's a dusty disk. So the dust kind of comes out of the star in the form of a disk, and this disk is an unsolved problem. Nobody knows when this disk appears and disappears. So this is a 150-year old unsolved problem. So how do we detect this disk? So I was telling you, it's a B-type star. It's very fast rotating and it's a thin disk. So, and why is it called emission, B-type emission star? Actually, the definition of a BE star is still a working definition. It's still not yet completely told what exactly is a BE star. So for time being, you people know about the basic atomic spectra, like the Slyman series, Balmer series, Bashkin series, Brackett series, Pfeiffer, and so on. So you know Balmer series has H alpha. H alpha's wavelength is 6563 angstrom. So we usually look into H alpha emission basically with respect to this detecting this disk. So if we see the H alpha in emission, when we take the spectra of this star, when we take a spectra of this star and we see an emission line especially in this region, 6563 angstrom to be specific. So if you see an emission in 6563 angstrom, then you say the disk is present. So and if you had seen it in emission, and after some days and after some years, maybe if you observe it again, and if you see 6563 angstrom for the same star being in absorption rather than in emission, you see a dip instead of an emission, you say the star has lost its disk and it has come back to its normal place. So when this phenomena occurs, like when this disk appears and disappears, it's still an unsolved problem for 150 years. And I am currently doing my research in this area, and it's totally a pure observational research. So I work with the Himalayan Satellite Scope data, and now currently I'm working with Vinababu data as well. I'm observing, it's basically observational thing. So it's a exciting field. Because it's many great people always say the unsolved problems are the reason that makes the subject real. So I can generalize it further and say, like, the unsolved problems in physics makes the physics a living subject. So this kind of puzzles actually, you might even win you a Nobel Prize in the future if you are able to solve it, because it's an unsolved problem for so many years, but you never know what Nobel committee thinks about. So that's there, but it will be a wonderful work, because many great bright minds are working on this, and bright minds have worked on it. So it is a a very challenging place where you can understand this. And it's very exciting to work with, because, you know, just imagine a star throwing away vomiting disk. Don't you think it's very exciting? So, do you want me to make such kind of this kind of exciting videos relating to astronomy and astrophysics? You know what to do. You have to subscribe my channel, give me a thumbs up, and support me. Thank you very much. See you in the next video.